Hello everyone, welcome to our first English class post summer break. I hope you all are ready with your book and pencil to read chapter number 4 from your book Honeycomb. The name of the chapter is The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. As I have told you earlier, I have divided the chapter into 3 parts. So today we will cover 1/3 part of the chapter. If I talk about the writer, then the name of the writer is William Elliot Griffiths, and he had written many Japanese tales, and this story is also a Japanese tale. Okay, and today in the first part we will cover these particular points, like old couple served dog as their baby, wicked couple become rich because of dog, wicked couple killed the dog. These are the key points which we are going to cover today. So let's start reading the chapter. First of all, page number 55, first para I'm going to read. So please pay attention towards your book. Okay, keep your eye on the book and listen carefully what I am reading. Okay, because you have to understand clearly the how to read the chapter, okay, and how to pronounce the word. At the same time, when I will explain it, then you have to keep it in mind, the complete explanation with the meanings of words. So let's start reading. In the good old days of Damios, there lived an old couple whose only pet was a little dog. Having no children, they loved it as though it were a baby. The old dame made it a cushion of blue crepe, and at mealtime Mugo, for that was its name, would sit on it as snug as any cat. The kind people fed the pet with tidbits of fish from their own chopsticks and all the boiled rice it wanted. Thus treated, the dumb creature loved its protectors like a being with a soul. So before to explain, I want to give the meanings of some words. So dear students, in the first line, last word Damios, underline this word and write down the meaning, wealthy land owners. Okay, as it is given in the book. Fourth line, last word dame, D-A-M-E, the meaning is woman. This word is used for woman. Next line, crepe, C-R-A-P-E, crepe is given. Write down the meaning. It is kind of cloth. Okay. And next, fourth line, tidbits. Tidbits meaning is food. And next fourth line, word is here, creature, which means animal. And last line, a phrase is here, being with the soul. Okay. And the meaning is like a human child. Okay, and as you have written the meaning of tidbits, above this a word is here, snug. Snug means comfortable. Okay, I hope you all have written the meanings. Now please listen the explanation. In the old good days of the Damios, it was the time of 19th centuries when the wealthy land owners lived in the Japan. Then there also lived an old couple, and they had a pet dog. Having no children, they loved it as though it were a baby. They had no child, the old couple had no child, so they loved the dog as if it were a baby. And the name of the dog was Mugo. Okay, the old lady made it a cushion of blue crepe. Now, what happened? The old lady made a cushion of blue crepe for the dog so that it could sit on it as cat sit comfortably. So the during the meal time, means during the lunch time or dinner time, the dog always used to sit on the cushion and feel comfortable. The kind people fed the pet with tidbits of fish. The kind couple offered the dog fish. The food for the dog was tidbits of fish, pieces of fish, and also they fed them with their own chopsticks. They use their own forks to feed the dog. So they never differentiate between him and them, and they always use their own forks to feed them and all the boiled rice it wanted. With fish, they also served him boiled rice. Thus treated, the dumb creature, the dumb animal, loved its protectors. Here, protectors, old couple, like a being with a soul. So like a human child, okay, the dog returned the love to his protectors. Okay, so the dog also loved them very much. He used to love as they love him. Okay, now next para, second para, half part is on the same page and half on the next page. So first of all, I am going to read the second para. So please listen carefully and look into your books. The old man, being a rice farmer, went daily with hoe or spade into the fields, working hard from morning until old and summer, as the sun is cold, had gone down behind the hills. Every day the dog followed him to work, never once harming the white heron that walked in the footsteps of old man to pick up the worms. For the old fellow was patient and kind to everything that had life, and often turned up a sword on purpose to give food to the birds. So dear student, first of all, write down the meaning. Third line, a phrase is given, O Tentosama. This is used for the sun for evening time. Okay. And on the next page, first line, word is given, heron, and the meaning is kind of bird. Last line, S-O-T, sort is given, that is kind of grass, and on purpose, intentionally. And above this line, turned up phrase is given, that means dug up. Okay. So what happened? The old man, being a rice farmer, means the old man was a farmer. The occupation of the man was farming, and went daily with hoe or spade. So hoe or spade, these are the tools which we use in the field. So he always went to the field with these tools and working hard from morning to evening. Had gone down behind the hills, and the field was behind the hills. There were hills, and behind the hills there were fields where the old man went daily for work. Every day the dog followed him to work, means the dog always went with the farmer, never once harming the white heron. Now listen carefully, dear students. A heron means a bird. Okay, so a bird always walked in the footsteps of the old man to pick up worms. Okay, but the old man never hurt the particular bird. And the same way, the dog never harmed the bird. Besides it, or you can say, instead of harming, the old man served the grass intentionally to the particular bird, so that the bird can use the grass as its food. Okay, so the kindness and generous, you can see, of the old man means the old man never hurt a single life, single thing which had life. Okay, so he was very kind person. He always give help to others, and similarly, a bird always used to sit on the footsteps so that the bird could use worms as its food. But the old man never harmed the bird. Instead of that, he always used to give him food in form of grass. Okay, let's move on to the next para. Okay, page number 56, second para. As you can see on the picture, okay, with the picture, second para is given in the book. So please listen carefully. One day the dog came running to him, putting his paws against his legs and motioning with him head to some spot behind. The old man at first thought his pet was only playing and did not mind it. But the dog kept on whinnying and running to and fro for some minutes. Then the old man followed the dog a few yards to a place where the animal began a lively scratching. Thinking it was possibly a buried bone or bit of fish, the old man struck his hoe in the earth. When lo, a pile of gold gleamed before him. So dear students, what happened? One day the dog came running to him. Just write down the meaning of some words. In the fifth line, whinnying is given. Whinnying means high pitched cry. Next line, to and fro phrase is given. The meaning is side to side. And last, gleamed is given, and the meaning is shown. One day what happened? The dog ran coming. He was running towards the man, and he was just making different kind of poses and motioning his head to some spot behind. Means he wanted to show his old man a particular place. The old man at first thought his dog was only playing. He had not, the old man had not paid any attention towards the dog because he thought the dog was playing only. But the dog kept on winning. The dog was crying at the loud sound and running to and fro for some minutes. And for some minutes he was grinning side to side. Then the old man followed the dog a few yards to a place. And then what happened? As the dog were becoming restless, so the old man went to some distance with the dog. And what happened? The dog started scratching the ground. He started scratching the field with the help of his paws. And to help his pet, as he was scratching, the old man struck his paw in the earth because he wanted to help the dog. So he struck the hoe, and now there was a pile of gold before him. The old man was thinking like he has smelled something, so might be there was a buried fish or some dead bodies were there. But what happened? They found a pile of gold there. Okay, so as they find gold, so what happened? But will there? Yes, they become rich. As they found gold, they become rich. Now see, on the next page number 57, first para is here. Thus, in an hour, the old couple were made rich. The good souls bought a piece of land, made a feast for their friends, and gave plenty of food to their poor neighbors. As for the dog, they petted him till they nearly smothered him with kindness. So dear student, write down the meaning of the word petted. Fourth line, last word petted, pampered. Last line, smother. Word is here, smother means loving someone. So in this paragraph, the writer had written about how they spent money. The old couple become rich, so they bought a piece of land, threw a party for their friends, and helped the poor neighbors, gave them some money. As for the dog, they petted him till they nearly smothered him with kindness. They showered their complete love. They loved the dog and pampered completely because of dog they become rich. They showered their complete kindness. They showered their full love. Now next para, second para of this speech. Now in the same village, there lived a wicked old man and his wife, not a bit sensitive and kind, who had always kicked and scolded all dogs whenever any passed their house. Hearing of their neighbor's good luck, they coaxed the dog into their garden and set before him bits of fish and other dainties, hoping he would find treasure for them. But the dog, being afraid of the cruel bear, would neither eat nor move. So, as good couple lived there, another way a bad couple was there. Okay, so what happened then? So only one, two words are there, coxed and dentist, and the meaning is given to you. So listen carefully the explanation, my dear students. Now in the same village, there lived a wicked old man and his wife, not a bit sensitive and kind. That couple was not sensitive at all. Okay, they never showed any kind of kindness to animals, especially to the dogs, who had always kicked and scolded all dogs whenever any passed their house. Whenever they saw that any dog passing through their house, they always used to kick them, beat them only, but they never shown any kind of sensitivity. Hearing of their neighbor's good luck, as they heard that their neighbors become rich, they coaxed the dog into their garden. They persuaded, they forced the dog and brought them into the garden and set before him bits of fish and offered the dog some foods in form of fish and other dainties. Other tasty food also they offered, hoping he would find treasure for them, because they were hoping that as the dog found treasure for old couple, and on the same way this dog also would find treasure for them. But the dog, being afraid of the cruel boy, as they behaving badly with the dog become afraid, he got frightened, from the cruel couple, from the wicked couple, would neither eat nor move. So the dog neither moving nor eat means he was becoming completely stunned. He was standing stable. He was not moving, not eating anything because he got frightened. Now on the same page, third paragraph is there. Then they dragged him out of doors, taking a spade and hoe with them. No sooner had the dog got near a pine tree growing in the garden than he began to paw and scratch the ground as if a mighty treasure lay beneath. So no difficult word is here, simple language they had used, and what they had said that then they dragged him out of door. As the dog becomes stunned, he was not moving, then forcefully they dragged the dog out of the door and taking spade. They both have different tools, spade and hoe, with them, and took out the dog into the garden. Now what happened? As the dog reached near a pine tree, he started scratching with the help of his paw. He started scratching the ground as if mighty treasure lay beneath. He started scratching as he found something good. He found some hidden treasure there. "Quick, wife, hand me the spade and hoe," cried the greedy old fool as he danced with joy. As he saw that the dog had started scratching, the old man filled with joy. He delighted. He danced. He was dancing, and he told his wife to hand it over the spade. Then the covetous old fellow. Now, dear student, it would be the last para for today. So listen carefully. Then the covetous old fellow, with a spade and all drawn with the hoe, began to dig. But there was nothing but a dead kitten, the smell of which made them drop their tools and shut their noses. Furious at the dog, the old man kicked and beat him to death. And the old woman finished the work by nearly chopping off his head with a sharp hoe. Then they flung him into the hole and heaped the earth over his carcass. Now what happened? How wicked they are. Then the covetous old couple. So write down the meaning of the word covetous. Covetous means greedy. And the next line, crone is given, that means old woman. And then there is the word furious. In the fifth line, furious is given, which means angry. Last line, last word, carcass, which means dead body of the animal. And before carcass, in the second last line, flung is given, which means through. So as the dog was not moving, and they forcefully dragged him into the garden, and the dog started scratching, and as they wanted to help the dog, they started digging the ground. But what they found? The greedy old fellow, the greedy old man with the spade, and the old lady with the hoe began to dig. They started digging the ground, but there was nothing. They found nothing but a dead kitten was there only. Then the smell was so much foul, the smell was so much stinky, that they just dropped out their tools and shut their noses. Furious at the dog, they become very angry. They become angry at the dog, and the old man kicked and beat him near to the death. Okay, the old man started beating the dog, and the dog just reached near to the death. But the old man, what she did? The old man finished the work by nearly chopping off his head, and the old lady, the chop cut down the head of the dog with the help of the hoe. Okay, and he finished the life of the dog. And afterwards, with the sharp, then they flung him, they threw the dog into the hole, which they both dug out, and heaped the earth over his carcass and over his body, over the dead body of the dog. They put the earth soil, and make a pile, make a heap there. Okay, so dear student, it is the last line, last para for today. Rest of the chapter we will cover in next 2 days. So please read the chapter, write down the meaning, and stay tuned for next part. Okay, so see you soon with next part of the chapter. Till then, stay connected, safe and positive. Thank you.